situation calls for even more good food and fun than usual! But what were you gossiping about just now? Paimon heard something about a secret. Birthday surprise? Yeah. Makes sense. So, do we have to keep talking like this until the festival ends? So what exactly are you planning? Now that we're in on the plan, we should do something to contribute! No trouble at all! We're more than happy to help! Forgot. Gotta keep it a secret. Delicious scents in the air today! The sea breeze in Port Ormos isn't even enough to cover them up! Well, with all these vendors, there's no way we're going back empty-handed! Just leave the haggling to us! Thank you.
Welcome! What can I get for you today? Ah, no problem at all. What'll it be? One sec. Let me jot this down. Potato boats, pani puri. All right. We'll have that ready as scheduled. That's a fairly sizable order. Of course. Let me see. That should come to 29,000 mora, but you can have it for 26,000. How's that sound?
Huh?
Ah, that's a bit tricky. We're going to be fairly busy that day, and we're setting aside all these ingredients for your order. In that case, the most I can offer is 20% off. Of course, of course. Thank you for your order.
So it turns out Candace is way better at haggling than us?
Oh, something you wanted to add to your order, miss? Oh, thanks for your concern, but I replaced the charcoal earlier today, so it should be...
Whoa! There's so much smoke!
Oh. I'm fine, thanks. It's just... That was so strange. it's certainly possible. I had a similar problem not too long ago. I thought switching to this one would fix the issue, but... I'm all right. It seems like you got a good eye, miss. Just wish your warning came a little earlier. Probably could have avoided this scenario entirely. In any case, I'll definitely fix the stove today, so don't worry about any delays. Sounds good. See you soon.
That was a close call. Good thing you're fast on your feet, Candace. Well, where should we go next? Preferably somewhere without any fire hazards. Paimon's still a little traumatized by what happened. Sounds good! It's been a while since we had the chance to shop at Port Ormos. Maybe we can pick up some other things along the way! The fruit stand should be that way. Candace, are you okay? Huh? I'm fine. Thank you, miss.
What happened?
That crate came out of nowhere! Luckily, Candace saved that little girl before she got hit!
Where are your parents, child?
They're at the tavern by the harbor. But I got bored, so I came out to play.
Go back to your parents now, child.
Okay.
Whose crates are these?
They're mine.
How many times have I told you not to leave heavy objects by the road? When are you gonna learn?
I'm sorry. It's just... we ran out of storage on our latest shipment.
And?
Nothing. I'll take care of it right away. I won't do it again.
Thank you, everyone. I should have been keeping a closer eye on everything. It's lucky you were here, Miss Candace. I really don't know how things would have turned out otherwise. I always feel like I could use an extra pair of eyes during Sabzura's season. I appreciate the reminder, Miss Candace. Anyway, you were probably in the middle of something, so I'll leave you to it. Enjoy the festival!
That was some quick thinking, Candace. It was like you leapt into action before the crate even started to fall! Wait, you mean... you saw the future? Have you told anyone else about this? Could the gem be the source of the visions? Maybe we could ask the others. Speaking of merchants, Paimon can think of someone who's always in the know. Although getting information out of her is definitely gonna cost us. Yep, that's the one! But, she's pretty touchy when it comes to Mora, so it's best not to haggle too much. Yikes, that's steep!
Really? Paimon feels kinda bad, though. We didn't turn out to be much help. Hopefully Dory got the intel we asked for. Let's head over and check! Candace, you're here! Have you seen Dory? Wow, she sure didn't waste any time. So, how'd it go? Did she tell you where the gem came from? So there's two? So where's the other gem now? You think it's related to the other gem? But what about the preparations for the Sub-Zero's festival? Hey, we're in this together. There's no way we're backing out now. we really are in the middle of nowhere. Planks over there?
Can't believe this. We made sure to pick a remote path and we still got ambushed. Ah! Who's there?
Guardian?
Calm down. I think we're safe. Pretty sure stealing's not in a guardian's job description.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Don't mind him. Some of our guys are still on edge after the robbery this morning. The robbery took everything from us. We can't just let that slide, so I'm taking my men to confront them and get back some of what they stole at least.
Hazardous materials.
For the love of... You can't just say that. Listen, it was just some firecrackers and fireworks. That's all.
But that's what the crates had written on them.
They're fireworks. What else would they be labeled as? Perishable goods? Ugh. Just ignore him, please. As you can see, some of my guys aren't particularly bright. If the guards at Caravan Rebot hear of this, we'll get questioned all over again. To some tribal camps in the desert. Everybody's looking to celebrate with the Sub-Zero's festival coming up. Even small businesses like us got a share of the orders. Mostly the long-distance transports that no one else wanted. Well, it was like this. We had just set out on the remote path when...
A web of thorns and vines suddenly blocked our way!
Vines?
What? No! Why would there be vines in the desert? Our wagon got stuck in the sand. That's what happened. I'm sure it was a trap. After that...
Bombs started falling from the sky!
Bombs?
Ugh, just stop talking. That robbery messed you up more than I thought. Don't listen to his nonsense. He's just a bit shaken up by what happened. Anyway, as we were trapped, the bandits started firing rockets at us, which made a lot of the fireworks go off. In the middle of all the chaos, they ran off with the rest of our stuff.
No, we couldn't really see anything. There was sand everywhere, and we were more preoccupied with getting out alive. Although, I did notice that one of the bandits had this green stone. Yes, exactly like that. I just couldn't make sense of it. If you already have something that valuable, why go after our cheap firecrackers? Well, all right. We'll just take another quick break before we head over.
So, one group of bad guys attacked the other? Hyman hopes the Sub-Zero's festival doesn't get ruined. Things are turning out to be more complicated than we expected.
Oh? And what things would those be? Sounds like something the General Mahamatra should know about.
Zaino, what are you doing here?
I'm here on business, investigating an unusual robbery case.
Wait, could it be the same one we've been investigating?
Just doing my duty. By the way, I brought something that I think might help with the investigation. Here, have some Parisara pudding.
Okay, thanks!
Well, find any clues? They say the proof is in the pudding, after all.
Did you have to tell that joke when Paimon had a mouthful of pudding? She almost choked!
Anyway, back to the matter at hand. Tell me more about this robbery case of yours. I see. So you and Candace already did a preliminary investigation.
Yep, Candace can tell you the rest when she gets back. That merchant group was really suspicious.
All right, you can leave the rest to me. On a different note, do you have any other plans for the day?
Head back with Candace. We're meeting up with everyone to prepare for the super awesome dinner we're planning tonight.
Strange. Sounds like you're hiding something from me.
What? No, not at all. We'd never do anything like that.
Do you know why Henneberries can't tell a lie?
Why?
Because they're always going to be red straight through. You think so? Then tell me your secret.
Seriously, there's no secret.
Is that so? You're not afraid of ending up like the bass in the lake?
What?
Because they always wind up eating their worms.
Yeah, who knew being interrogated by the General Mahamatra was this miserable? Candace! Thank goodness you're back. Please save us.
Nice to see you, Candace. The Traveler already updated me on everything, so you can leave the robbery case to me. But when I asked about their plans this afternoon, they started dodging my questions.
Candace! It's supposed to be a secret! What? Why didn't you say something sooner?
Well, once you told me about the case, I realized I might not make it this afternoon. I was going to ask you to tell the group, but you decided to end the conversation.
Seriously? So we had to listen to a couple of Sino jokes for nothing?
Well, with that resolved, could you tell the group I've got a case? Oh, and these are the items I was supposed to get. Could you take them back with you?
Sure thing, we've got this.
I would hope so. I just handed it to you.
Oh, enough already! Finally free from all those terrible jokes. That explains why he had all those jokes ready to go, even while on the job. Paimon will never understand how he doesn't give himself a cringe attack. Candace? Did you have another vision? Dangerous? Maybe they're the bandits from earlier. Then let's sneak up on them. If they're the ones looking to cause trouble during the Sub-Zero's festival, we should catch them in the act! Hey, did you hear that? Sounds like they're talking about something dangerous. It's you two? Oh, what kind of terrible plan were you talking about just now?
Something about explosions and the flower carriage? Okay, so that's what all this was about? Well, about that. Maybe you could dumb that down a little. The past? Explain what we saw. Missing. What's that thing coming toward us right now? Candace, something on your mind? Thank you. mention it? Or are we meeting in the city? Wouldn't that be more convenient? That was too close.
desert.
Want to buy flowers?
What's going on? How can there be Kairagi?
How did it come to this?
Ah, you must be Hat Guy. I've heard Sethos talk about you recently.
And you must be the General Mahamatra. Don't tell me you're also in the habit of convincing people to go to festivals.
No, just had to check something at the academia and thought I would stop by. But I am rather curious about you.
Huh?
Do you play Genius Invocation TCG?
No.
Hmm, that's good.
Huh?
Do you know what would happen if you did play?
I don't play.
You'd beat me 3 times in a row. A real hat trick?
Time to meet up with everyone again. We need to go to Party Steop. Come on, let's go check out how the preparations are going.
Maybe she overslept.
Looking so worried. Oh, maybe she's just running late.
But I was told she had left first thing this morning.
And now Sino's here, but Nilu's still nowhere to be found.
We interrogated the people in charge of the caravan on the day of the incident. But they were technically the victims of the case, and all their goods were lost, so there was no evidence to investigate. Their goods are certainly suspicious, but until we recover them, all we can do is to observe the caravan under the guise of protection. We contacted the original seller of the gem. Apparently, he sold the other half to a young man in the desert, but that's all he could tell us.
Wait, you think Nilu's disappearance is connected to all this?
Traveler, Candace, there's no time to waste. Let's try to follow her trail. Tainari, can you stay back and explain the situation to everyone when they arrive?
Oh, hello. Did you need something?
We're looking for Nilu. Do you know where she is?
Nilu? She left bright and early this morning. Said she had to help out a friend.
Was she by herself? And did you happen to see which gate she used to leave the city?
Well, she definitely left alone. As for the direction, I think she left through the gate to the north.
So, the complete opposite direction of Pardis Dii.
Did something happen? This is no time for practical jokes, you know.
Mr. Zubair, could you send word to Pardis Dii if Nilu comes back to the Grand Bazaar?
Of course. I'm sure she just got caught up in something. Still, let me know if you find her.
We will. All right. Let's leave through the North Gate and see what we can find. Miss Navita, have you seen Nilu this morning?
Nilu? Oh yes, I saw her head out of the city. She was wearing the prettiest outfit.
Which way did she go?
That way, I believe.
Was there anyone following her? Did everything look okay?
I mean, it looked like she was in a good mood. She even stopped to say hello. And no, I didn't see anyone else.
All right. Thank you. Excuse me. Have any of you seen Miss Nilu from Zubair Theater come this way?
Yes, General. I saw Miss Nilu cross the bridge after leaving the city this morning. There was a man waiting for her on the other side.
Wait, could that be the person who bought the second gem?
Did you see the man's face?
Unfortunately, no. He was too far away.
Understood. If she comes back this way, tell her to find me at Pardis Dii.
Yes, General.
Let's keep going. With this many traces, it's easy to get mixed up. Let me take a closer look. Sure. We'll continue analyzing the footprints over here.
Question. Did you see a girl walk by? Really? Which way did she go? A messy pile of rocks? Oh, that makes sense! Thank you, Arasaka. Arasaka, about the other thing you mentioned. Well, guess that ends this conversation. Well, let's tell Sino and Candace what we learned.
The Fane of Ashwata? Where did you get this information?
Well, we were tipped off by some friends. We can vouch for the information.
All right. I trust you. Another vision? Was Nilu one of the voices? Let's head towards the ruins for now. The vision could mean we're on the right track. We should be getting close.
This area is usually full of treasure hoarders. Nilu could be in danger. It's Nilu! Hey!
I don't think she can hear us. We're too far away. What are you doing here?
Can't we stick to one question at a time? Oh wait, that one doesn't count.
What dreadful cacophony! Are we not allowed a quiet place to practice?
Ah, Pale Floater. And my Yasna Potty.
You know this red floating being?
Excuse you. I, Sorush, am a noble Pari, and the Bloom Guard of Quarina.
Sorush is a Pari we met in the Vorukasha Oasis. She's really nice. You just have to get used to the way she talks. So you are the one who bought the other gem!
A Ouijat Eye Pari. Sounds like something I've read about before. Now's not the time for riddles. Everyone in the city is still worried about Nilu.
Message? What message?
Tell me Roshnu fell asleep halfway there. Again!
Oh, hearing that name, this is all starting to check out.
Who's Roshnu?
Hold on, let's take this one thing at a time. First, what are you guys doing here? Sarush, they're here!
I've had enough of these insufferable rascals! Wreaking havoc in the desert, right and left! Wake up, Roshnu! We need to teach them a lesson, or we'll never get another good night's sleep!
I'll trap them with my thorns when they pass by, and you can take care of the rest.
Perfect! They don't stand a chance! Let's give them a taste of sheer terror!
What in the... thorns?!
Boss! The wagon is stuck!
Huh?
Now! Behold my might!
Bombs! There are bombs falling from the sky!
Stop panicking!
Perish, you scoundrels! Who might you be? Brazen youth! Have you any idea to whom you speak? So
So you're not entirely ignorant after all. Fine, I'm willing to call it a day. But if those scoundrels continue to disrupt the peace of this land, I will show no mercy!
You really can get along with anyone, huh?
Sethos fulfilled his duty well. I have come here for a monumental task.
What task?
I heard Lesser Lord Kusanali is currently celebrating her birthday in the city. As her familiars, the Pari have decided to bestow upon her a special gift. As decided by Elder Zervin, the Bloomguard of the Pari, that would be me, will present the Dance of Sebzerus to Lesser Lord Kusanali, a tradition passed down over the centuries. Good thing I did. How was I to know the current version is nothing like the original?
Well, there are bound to be changes over the centuries.
I appreciated young Nilu's determination, so I invited her here to practice in peace.
Oh, so that's what happened. Feels like we've been chasing bad guys for days, but in the end, there were no bad guys at all. It was all for Nahida's surprise.
That would explain why they chose a remote path away from Aru Village. They're lucky you didn't catch them in the act.
Okay, remind Paimon not to get on Candace's bad side. Oh yeah! What exactly is this thing?
It was a gift from King Deshret to Lesser Lord Kusanali. I only know the basics. I never thought these two gems could be connected to the relic from the legend. But the Wijadai was lost after the cataclysm in Khanria, buried deep beneath the sands.
And Lesser Lord Kusanali turned the Quarina into a divine bird, tasked with guarding the border between new birth and death, until the bird shattered into pieces and gave rise to the Pari.
So Candace actually saw things recorded by the Wijadai.
Technically, the eye belongs to Lesser Lord Kusanali. Why don't you just give it back?
understand your reasoning, but if this is the decision of the group, as well as my Yasnapati, then I shall object no further. Well, are you going to let me teach the girl the dance of Sub-Zeros, or do you intend to drag this on incessantly?
She's got a point. Now that we know it was all a false alarm, let's go back and tell everyone what happened. They're probably worried.
I'll tell the other Matra to keep an eye out for that caravan. If we find evidence of any misconduct, we won't let them off lightly.
Focus! No more distractions! Now, follow along! Watch closely. One and two and...
It was all just a misunderstanding. How are the preparations going?
I think I'll check it over later, though. We were so worried about you all, it was kind of hard to focus.
Great! We don't have to worry about missing the parade!
Actually, I have a favor to ask as well. These are the decorations for the flower carriage. Could you bring them to the sanctuary of Surasthana and hang them on the carriage? Oh, it would mean a lot to have the Knight of Flowers personally decorated.
You can count on us! Done. Now we just have to go to the sanctuary of Surasthana and hang the decorations on the flower carriage! Huh. Wonder what the sanctuary looks like the night before the festival. Let's go check it out!
Thank you.
That should be good. All we need to do now is wait for the parade tomorrow.
Are those Parisaras?
Thank you.
On that topic, I wonder how much it's worth. An alarm. Yes, that's what I heard just now. Dear friends, a critical moment has arrived. It is time to come together and play Genius in...
You have a long life ahead of you. Isn't it too early to draw such a conclusion? Thank you for your kindness, Great Archon. But we Pari have our own duties, and we find the city a bit too noisy. True. I have fond memories of my adventures with Pale Floater and my Yasnapati.
Aw, really? Paimon's happy to hear that. It felt like this Sub-Zero's festival had surprises for everyone. When you called out the Arenara, Paimon nearly fell out of the sky in shock. No wonder Arasaka was so flustered. He was trying to keep it a secret. Oh, Paimon's sure everyone in Sumeru loved the surprise. It felt like a dream. Nahida?
Is reserved for the mighty Pari.
Oh, Paimon's the only one allowed to float next to him.
Happy birthday!
Thank you. expenses.
Day.
Order guide.
Check this out. That's the launch.
How's this?
Out of the frying pan, into the fire. Easy.
This isn't over. Cheap kicks.
Let the magic veins boil.
Stabilize!
I will have order!
Carving waves! Yes. Off we go!
Kill my blade! How's that? Perfect distance!
Off we go! Booba, get them!
There's more!
Order guide you!
Solidify!
Carving wave! Need a surfboard?
Letting brave names echo! Bring it!
Action at the
Let's get down to business.
This is order.
Shower me with praise. Time to shine.
There's more.
Nice and spicy. Eat this.
There's more.
Let's get down to business.
Stabilize. Order guide you.
Strike a pose. Let's ride. Let's shred, Sharky. Out of the frying pan, into the fire.
Yeah.
Carving wave.
I'm ready.
I see your power.
Let's have some fun, shall we?
This is order.
Brain of bullets!
Who wants some of this?
Alright,
you asked for it.
Take this.
Get this way!
Press the advantage! Let's roll!
You are not welcome here.
You picked the wrong fight.
Gather. I will have order.
Charge! Oni coming through. Bam!
I am the cutting edge of fashion.
Attaboy! Pull in! Everyone on me!
Order guide you.
Let's roll! It's showtime!
What?
fine.
Let the magic veins boil!
Ignite Phantasmal.
Order guide you. Gather!
Watch out! And bring it! Letting great names echo!
Hey there! Chat attack! That's the way. Chat hiya!
Solidify!
I will have order!
Reveal thyself!
As you wish, Maid Fräulein.
Hear the echoes of the valley!
Ha, watch out! Take proper send up! From the Spina with love!
Gather! Order guide
you! Letting great names echo!
escape. Let me lead you a breath. Rain outlines your fate.
Huh? Torn to oblivion. Shine down.
This is order.
Many great names echo.
Crumble.
There is no escape.
Know my storm. Ring cutter.
Rise.
Now you shall perish.
Order guide you.
Let the mountain flames boil!
Crumble!
Rain outlines your fate. Witness the power of Gowa.
Shine down. Torn to oblivion.
I will have order.
Bring it. Hear the echoes of the valley. There is no escape.
Rain cutter.
Order guide you.
Inazuma shines eternal. Illusion shattered. There is no...
I will have order. Quake!
Letting great names echo.
Now you shall perish.